Welcome to Coburn Family Kitchen. I guess still got Carla here with me. They go back, they've made a revelation. They go back the 13th of January, and they've decided to sell their house and move down to Florida. I guess they're tired of that hard white stuff too. Don't yes. blame them. So, what we're gonna do today is we're gonna make a spaghetti salad. And it sounds weird, but it's really good. We got bowl games coming up and everything like that, so this goes really great at a party. So let's get started. And what I've done is I've done a pound of spaghetti. We're not going to say, but it's pot-sized spaghetti, but I'm not going to say the brand name. So get rid of that, okay? Now, been married to the wife 27 years. She says, Don, will you check the pasta? 27 years ago now. So what I do is I take a knife when it's boiling in the pot, and if you just lay your knife across it and don't put any pressure on it, and it goes, your pasta's perfect. You don't have to throw it up against the wall. I'm not going to do that in my kitchen. I cook in here. But since I have showed her that trick, let me tell you what.
She still
every time she
does
pasta, she comes out and gets me. It's a no-win situation. So what we've got here is we've got 16 ounces of, I'm not going to say to do a dollop of whatever, but 16 ounces of sour cream. Got a cup of mayonnaise, a quarter cup of green onions. I've got a jar of this slaw mix. And then what I've got here is two English cucumbers. I've already diced up one. Well, actually Carla has, because I'm a cripple. My back is still gone. So I'm gonna have her dice that up while I add all these ingredients to the bowl. So we're going to start with our spaghetti. Well, I pulled it out and I actually put ice cubes in it because I wanted a quick cool on it, which it did. And I ran it over water until the ice cubes melted, and I kept stirring it up with the old pasta thing. I don't know what they call these things. A funky fork.
They're probably yelling in the video right now. Yeah, it's called this.
Whatever. Yeah. Hey, you want to make a comment? Tell me what the hell that thing's called, okay? Anyway. Let's get back to the salad here. What we got here is English cucumbers. Now those English cucumbers have been diced up. And they call them English cucumbers or burpless.
Burpless.
Burpless. Hey, whatever floats your boat, okay? So we're gonna take all these. That's two English cucumbers. This is a very bright dish. Now, you can get this, I can't say Marzotti slaw mix. Oh, it's dressing. So I guess I can't say that. And we're gonna take half of this. Okay. We're gonna put that in there. And then, we're gonna take some dill. Now, you can use fresh dill. What the heck? I just used the dill weed. I'm gonna sprinkle all that. Oh, I'd say about a little bit, not quite a bunch. You know how I love to measure. Now we're gonna mix all that up. I'll tell you what the dill does is it makes everything bright. I mean, it just makes it taste like it's so fresh. And new. So we're gonna mix all that up. I used to only put one cucumber in there, but everybody said they didn't get enough cucumber. So you gotta make everybody happy. Yeah. So you can do it to your taste. So get that all mixed up in there good. See how the dill's gone all over everything. Okay, so what you want to do now is put this in the refrigerator overnight. And overnight, it's going to absorb a lot of that into the spaghetti and into the cucumber. And it's going to it just tastes fantastic, I gotta tell you. I mean, it may be a little foo-foo for some of us guys, but hey, it's good. I'll just eat it when the wife's around, you know, that way I can be foo-foo too. So, the next day, we're going to pull it out. We're going to put the other half of this jar in there. And you won't believe the difference when you put it in the refrigerator. You pull it out the next day, you see almost no saw mix. It almost looks like it turned into Parmesan cheese. So the next day we're going to put that on. And I'm going to tell you, it can't get any easier than that. So, I'd like to thank Carl for being my little sous chef on that one. But we're going to do another dip. Yeah, well, I call it a dip. That'd be a dip. So, we're going to set this.
Go in the fridge.
In the fridge. And tomorrow morning, we will have spaghetti salad. Now, some people call it cucumber salad. I actually learned that from a lady about 15 years ago who writes for she writes recipes for the Boston Sun or Boston Globe or whatever it is. And so I swapped her a recipe, which was the Reuben dip. And she gave me this one. And I'll tell you what, it's been a hit ever since. Now, what are we gonna do? We're gonna do a spinach dip. Now, spinach dip, I'm going to say that one is, what do you think? Easy.
Easy, I would say.
I'll say easy.
Easy.
So what I got here is a 10-ounce box of frozen spinach. Now I thawed it, I drained it, and I actually take my hands and I squeeze. I want to get all the water out of that thing. So I thawed and drained it. So then to this, we're going to make, oh, I'd say, I got a cup of mayonnaise here, and I also got mixed some of the sour cream in with it. I'm going to use a little dollop of Daisy here. Well, actually, I'm going to use a bunch. You know how I love to measure.
It's 16 ounces.
It is 16 ounces, thank you. God, if it ain't Teddy talking, I'm going to tell you what.
We got to keep you in line, Mr. Don. Yeah.
People don't know my first name. Oh. Hey, give me
Mr.
comments.
Coburn, how's
there
that?
You go. Yeah.
Yeah, give me comments and everything. So we got that in there. I guess we can stir a little bit of that up here. Now, tell you the truth, I don't like spinach. I don't know why, but I love this stuff. So that just do I like spinach or don't I like spinach? I don't know. I just can't eat this stuff hot. I can't wait for this stuff.
Me neither.
So while we're mixing all that, we're going to take, you can use a Lipton mix or Knorr's vegetable mix. If I can say that, sorry. Yeah, whatever. We're going to take a package of that. We'll scoop that in there. Can't wait for the bowl games. Go Buckeyes. I guess. Gators didn't go anywhere. All right. Thank God the Bucks are done. Good Lord. Then this is an 8-ounce diced water chestnuts. I'm going to dump him right in there. Thank you, sous chef.
You're welcome, sir.
Quarter cup of chopped green onion. Going to go in there. Sous chef. Sous chef.
Thank you, sir.
Woman.
There you go. That's more like it.
I think Gosh. that's what Bear would say.
That's right. It's more like a woman.
Bear, I think Bear, I'm still thinking about you, man. You're not getting the craps over the Mexican dip. You cracked me up, okay? And you made it. So we got all this. Oh, I got a new guy that likes to comment. Country Geo. Well, let me say a shout out to you, Country Geo. Don't know many Geos. I lived in Texas that were country. But hey, if that's who you are, that's who you are. It's gotta be better than, you know, well, redneck Geo, that'd be good too. Country Geo's fine. So now I've got all this mixed up. So what we're gonna do is you wanna put this in the refrigerator and you wanna get it chilled down real well. Then the next step is we go over here to Mr. Brad. Now, this is a pumpernickel. You can use wine bread, pumpernickel, whatever you like. We're gonna get a knife. Oh, I wouldn't say a dagger. I'll say a knife. And we're gonna go around this thing. I don't know who sharpened this, but
good. Obviously no one. Try this.
Oh, he went in the spoon drawer.
Yeah. Yeah. Spoon drawer for a knife. How's that?
Now we're cooking. We're cooking without actually even cooking.
That's how you like that?
That's the cool part. Where the hell did I start? Okay.
There you go.
You're going to bring some of that out. Then you're going to pull out some of these insides here. Now you can cut this up. Oh, isn't that pretty? Little bowl of stuff here. Looks like I got to pull more out. My sister taught me this recipe in 1984. Damn, I'm getting old. No wonder the back hurts so much. Between the wife riding on it, me working. So what we're going to do is we're going to put this dip. After it chills down, then we're going to pour it in here. Then you can take this bread, you can cut it up, you can set that on the side. Let's say cut it up, set that on one side of your platter, and then take an assortment of crackers and set them on the other side of the platter. You got a pretty looking platter, and tell you what, I like it. And that, again, I thought was easy.
Easy.
So, you want to taste it, and let me go to spoon drawer. Just get a gist of what these people want to...
They're going to get a gist of this?
Okay. Yes. Let them know what they think.
Very good.
Good.
Yep.
Okay. So, I'm going to let this chill down, and I think I've explained what you're going to do when it's chilled. Goes in the bowl, bread bowl. So, till next time, have a happy new year, and
stay safe.
Stay safe, and see you from Coburn Family Kitchen.